Other than North Korea's mass dug-in artillery forces, Pyongyang's enormous and well-training special operations forces are the most dangerous threat facing the United States and the South. According to U.S. military sources, Pyongyang's special operations troops are well-trained and well-equipped and pose a significant danger. As Washington ratchets up the pressure on North Korea or potentially launches a preemptive strike, the Kim regime in Pyongyang has options to strike back hard at the United States and South Korea using purely conventional means. While analysts often focus on the so-called Democratic People's Republic of Korea's arsenal of ballistic missiles, the real threat emanating from the North comes in the form of heavy artillery and special operations forces, which could wreak havoc on the South. In the event of a war on the Korean Peninsula, Pyongyang's ground forces are the greatest threat to the Republic of Korea, ROK, and the U.S. forces stationed there short of nuclear weapons. What a war between China and Japan would look like. With 70% of the ground force positioned south of the Pyongyang Wonsan Line, North Korea is maintaining a military posture capable of conducting a surprise attack at any time, reads the South Korean Ministry of National Defense 2014 Defense White Paper. In particular, the 170mm self-propelled guns and 240mm MRLS multiple launch rocket systems in forward positions are capable of surprise, massive concentrated fire on the Greater Seoul Metropolitan Area, ZMA. The 300mm MRL currently under test development by North Korea is able to reach the middle part of the ROK considering its maximum firing range. Additionally, North Korea has reinforced its artillery forces with 122mm towed MLRS systems in the coastal area near the West Sea coast and near the front lines. The North Korean artillery pieces would be protected by covered trenches to enhance their survivability during combat operations. Altogether, the South Korea estimates that the North has some 8,600 pieces of tube artillery and 5,500 MLRS batteries available to its forces. Meanwhile, North Korea is also modernizing its armored forces, but the mechanized troops are not the main focus of the regime in Pyongyang. Equipment modernization is also constantly pursued, such as replacing the existing T-54 and T-55.